Hello friends, in this lecture we'll derive the formula for the radius of curvature in different forms, in Cartesian, in parametric, in for implicit function, as well for impolar. So the basis is same, basis we'll discuss in Cartesian coordinate, and the other formula will be, you can derive the formula for radius of curvature. Find the radius of curvature for Cartesian curve y is equal to fx. Y is a function of x. Now the equation of the equation of the given curve is y is equal to fx. Fx. Now we have drawn the curve. This is equal to AB is the curve. AB is the curve given by this equation, and we want to find the radius of curvature. This row at this point, because we know that the steady curvature changes from point to point. So at this point, we're finding it at point P. Point P and Q is a neighborhood point, and P and Q are very close. So delta S, delta S. Now let's draw tangent at P, tangent to P, which makes angle by the positive x. Now the slope of tangent at P will be given by. So tangent will be, at the point will be tangent of sine. Now, if we differentiate the curve at P, at the arbitrary point P, we'll get the slope. So differentiate y is to x, another slope. Both the slopes, the first and second, they're still the same line at the point P. So they must be equal. Including the second and third, so you've got y1 is equal to, differentiate y is to x is equal to tangent of sine. So now this equation, fourth equation, differentiate this with to S on two sides. S is the arc length. This is S. So this is delta. This is delta small. P and Q are very close. This is very small. So this is straight line. It is very small, and P and Q are very close. This is straight line. So differentiate this, so fourth with to S. So differentiate both sides. So differentiate y is to x. So dx, ds of differentiate y is to x is equal to. Now this is the function of psi. So differentiate this with space. This will be now chain rule. We split this equal to s multiplied by dx divided by dx, and this will become the subsetting root of y is to x into differential of x is to s is equal to differential of this tangent is equal to secant square psi d psi dx. Now d psi, put this. Rho is equal to kappa, and kappa is equal to rate of change of the curvature. This is equal to, and this is equal to, so rho is equal to ds. So this is s is to psi. So now substitute the value of this. What is this? Dx ds. Now this is a triangle. A triangle. You know the tangent of psi is equal to perpendicular base, and ds is the arc length. Very small, so straight line. So the if tangent of psi is equal to differential y is to x, then cos of psi will be equal to dx divided by ds, and the sine of psi is equal to divided by ds. So it's a two variable. Now we want to find this row, which is curvature. This will take this to the right hand side, to the left hand side. So this will become ds d psi, and the other to the left hand side. Equal to cos of square psi upon cos of psi upon second derivative y is to x into this equal to substitute so dx ds is equal to cos of psi. So after substitution these values, what is this? Ds d psi is rho, rho is equal to ds d psi, and this is equal to, and this will go to the numerator secant cube. The cos equal to secant. Secant cube psi upon second derivative y square. Now secant psi is equal to 1 plus 10 square psi and root this. Secant psi is equal to 10. Secant square then, psi is equal to 1 plus 10 square, therefore secant psi is equal to 1 root of 1 plus 10. So putting that there. And what is this? 10 psi is equal to y. Y is equal to 1 square. জুড়ে গেলে দিস ফর্ম দ্য ইস টু রো ইজ ইকুয়াল টু বাই ইন কার্টেসিয়ান ফর্ম ইজ 1 প্লাস y বাই স্কয়ার আপন রো ইজ ইকুয়াল টু নাও ইফ দ্য ফাংশন we have derived this formula for y is function of x. But if x is a function of y, we know that the curvature of a curve at any point is independent of the coordinate system. It doesn't depend on the coordinate system, but depends upon the shape of the curve. I told you that the curvature of a point varies from point to point. So that's what it depends on the shape of the curve. Therefore, if the function, you are given a function y, x is a function of y, then again you can find, if you can convert a function, x is a function of y, then rho will be by 1 plus, first it will be x raised to y, x square is 50 by 2 upon x, second by 2, x is 2y. Then x is 2, you can say x is y, and this will be x equal to 2, so that will be x. And then Cartesian form when x is a function of y. This formula for when y is a function of x. So it's both ways. Because it's very important thing, the curvature of curve at any point is independent of the coordinate system, but depending upon the shape of the curve. In the shape. Now let's say formula for radius of curvature at any point of the curve in parametric. The curve is parametric form, then how will you find the radius curvature? Find the radius curvature at any point to the curve x is a function of t, y is a function of t. Given equation is x is a function of t, y is a function of t. X is equal to ft, y is equal to t. Differentiate both is to t, which x is to t is equal to f dash t, which y is to t, f dash t. Therefore, differential of y is to x is equal to y is to t, so x is to t is equal to w. Differential of y is to x is equal to g dash t upon f plus t. The same term. Now, equation is only equation in parametric form. Now, differentiate this. This is 2, x. Central y is to x equal to, which is this. Y is to x, dx of this. Dx of cannot be, because this function of t. Which is to t, divided by t, multiplied by t. So, this dx of y is to t. Now substitute the value dt dx. What is dt dx? Dt dx will be equal to dx will be equal to 0. Dt dx into f plus t. Substitute the value. It's equal to dt of this, root whole square, root minus d root 0. And dt dx is equal to 1 upon f. Dx is equal to f plus t, that is dx. Now simplify it. Now simplification. Substitute the value. Substitute the value of y then. Substitute the value. Rho is equal to 1 plus y1 to the square. Rho is equal to 1 by 2. Substitute the value from y1. Y1 from here. Y1 from here. C by 1. Y1 is C by 1. Is equal to y1 and is equal to substitute the values here. After substitution the values, so we got this coming part given time. So f dash square, but you just work with f dash g plus 1 g plus f dash. Now next formula for this picture. Find the formula for radius curvature when x and y are the function of r. Again, we are given the equation of this x is function of s, y is function of x, r length. Therefore, differential of x is to s is equal to positive psi. We know that. How to is equal to? Differential of y is equal to f is curve, which is y is to x, which is slope. Then you have psi at any point P, which is at any point P slope, tangent at any point P, those equal, so you can make a arc length. Point P and point, this is point P, this is the point P, and this is actually very close to me. So this is argon 3 composite, the carbon color statement, very close to each other. Right? So dS, this is here. So dx, dS will be cos of dy dx equal to tangent psi, therefore dx upon dS is equal to cos of psi, and dy upon dS, dS is equal to sin psi. That's it. So dS, dx, dS is equal to cos psi, dy, dS is equal to sin of psi. Therefore, now differentiate them. This cos minus sin psi and d psi is s. So this y square is equal to second derivative of y square equal to dx of sin psi cos psi dx sin square psi. So you know that psi and s is equal to 1 by 2. Substitution. Now squaring and adding. Minus sin psi upon second derivative of x is to s, from this also, we can calculate cos psi upon second derivative of y is to 3. X and y function of the r. Now, the radius curvature for implicit function approximation. So, you can also write this equation. For this, for implicit function, this we have to be equal to fx square, fy square, what is equal to fxx, same with the x, which x, fy, equal to y, which x, y, both here, and u, equal to f, which x, y, fx, equal to x, equal to x, y, plus u, at the center of the f, which y, fx, same with the x, which is equal to x, and for the implicit function. Find the value, substitute. For the radius curvature in the polar form, we have to find the value equal to, we take the value by r equal to f of 3. R square plus f, derivative for this theta whole square, equal to r square plus 2, derivative for r theta. Minus 2 r and r, then take r, same to r, so, and the work, in the